welcome, welcome, welcome to The Tonight Show. You're here. You made it. Thank you. Thank you all for being here. I just want to say happy Thanksgiving Eve. Yes. Tonight is actually known as Drinksgiving. And a lot of people are going to reconnect with their high school ex. If you watch closely tomorrow, you'll notice half the parade is just people doing the walk of shame. And I just... Of course, the difference between Drinksgiving and Thanksgiving is drinking for fun versus drinking for survival. Yeah, it's nice to let loose on Drinksgiving, but it's not good when your friend's like, I also celebrate Drinksmas, Drinkica, Drinkwanza, Drinka de Mayo. That's right, Thanksgiving is almost here. It's one of my favorite holidays, but let's be honest, it can be a little tense. I mean, that's why for the turkey, I use a dry rub made of crushed Xanax. Speaking of stress, I heard that a record number of people traveled today. Yeah, it seems like a lot of Americans are hitting the road. Just check out this news report from Los Angeles. It's real.
A live look at traffic. Oh, look at that. AAA predicts more than 49 million people will drive this holiday.
Oh, my God. It looks like your uncle's arteries after dinner tomorrow. You okay, buddy? You haven't said anything in 5 minutes. Your Apple Watch is smoking. You know there's one guy in that traffic thing that's like, if I could just get over to the one lane, I could. Meanwhile, according to the FAA, today was also supposed to be the busiest day for air travel. Look at this flight map.
Oh.
Sadly, that's just the path of one Spirit flight from Jacksonville to Minneapolis. Couple layovers and... Actually, that's the map of scheduled flights. Here's the map of flights that actually took off. There you go. Millions of Americans are flying this week. I am, too. And the one thing I can't recommend enough is signing up for those text alerts from the airline. They're great. I mean, they make sure that they... Oh, here's one now.
Oh.
Your flight will now leave from gate C-28.
Oh,
see?
Good.
Great. It's helpful to know that stuff. Anyway, your flight is delayed 5 minutes. Got it. Doesn't make a huge difference, but I appreciate it. Your gate is now changed to B-19. It seems like a lot of changes, but, you know, your pilot's name is Gregory. Why do I need to know that? I don't know. Gregory got food poisoning at Chili's, too. Your new pilot is Terry, and this is his first flight. I don't want to know that. Now I'm worried. Your gate has changed to D-42 next to Auntie Anne's. Well, that's actually good. I love Auntie Anne's. Psych, your gate has changed to A6 next to the Chili's too. No, that's what got Captain Gregory. Is there anything else near that gate? Just a Hudson News that sells gum for 14 bucks. Enough, no more notifications until I'm at LaGuardia. Your flight has been moved to JFK. Well, that's it, I'm turning it off. No more alerts from Delta, no more. You have a DM on Instagram. Sorry, I should... check out what this is. It could be important. It says, surprise, sucker. It's Delta and your flight's got...
Oh, come on.
Oh, and this is always fun. Tonight over at Macy's, they blew up the balloons for the Thanksgiving Day parade. Yeah. Or as Fox News put it, more inflation. Thanks, Biden. Right now, there's so much helium in the air, security's like,
let's go, let's keep it moving, people. Come on, come on. You say something, say something.
It's actually a great family event. Just cover your kids' eyes when SpongeBob's nose starts to inflate. All right.
Oh, my God.
Well, we've all heard about the first Thanksgiving, but I was flipping through the channels last night, and I came across a Ken Burns documentary about the first Friendsgiving. And it seems like the traditions are pretty much the same. Take a look at this.
My dearest Eleanor, unable to spend Thanksgiving with the family this year, myself and a few companions decided to have what we called a Friendsgiving. It was potluck. Clara brought an overcooked turkey. Alice brought a sack of rolls she clearly grabbed on the way over. Ethel, for whatever reason, brought paella. Ezra brought a friend he didn't tell anyone he was inviting. And Abe complained that he's now vegan and there was little for him to consume. The wine was cheap, boxed. But to make the food taste better, we all got lit AF. It It's now 2 a.m. and everyone is still refusing to GTFO. Forever yours, Samuel.
Oh, that's interesting. Well, some more news. I saw that tomorrow President Biden will air campaign ads during the Detroit Lions Green Bay Packers game. Yeah, Biden on Thanksgiving. It's like the waiter saying, would you like some Z-Quil to go with your tryptophan? You guys see this? Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene just released her new memoir. Yeah, it's the first memoir written in all caps. It's titled, Are You There, King of the Lizard People? It's me, Marjorie. It's just... You can find it in bookstores, heckling the other books. That's right, it's now available on Amazon, at Barnes & Noble, and wherever other fine books are burned. You guys, it's time for a show of hands. This is where we show you what politicians are doing with their hands while they're giving speeches. Enjoy.
In my acceptance speech 3 weeks ago, I said a strong America is good for the entire world, and I believe that. We believe that to our core. So we call on our Senate colleagues, we call on the White House to get that measure completed.
Meeting with the Vice Minister of Public Security of China to advance the removal of Guo from the United States.
But that's okay to say. And you know, you gotta remember, Biden's not too old. I know a man that
Florida has been a refuge for those who have been fleeing disastrous policies imposed by leftist state and local governments. And Florida.
Now, on a related matter, as I've said for months, Congress also has a responsibility to help our nation meet a growing network of serious threats.
Yeah, it's interesting. Very good to see what they do. Finally, a woman on a flight to France gave birth when the plane was about to take off. Just before it happened, her seatmate was like, phew, no screaming babies on this flight. We have a great show. Give it up for the Roots, ladies and gentlemen. Speaking of lists, our buddy over here, the lead singer here for the Roots, Tariq Trotter, has a book out, The Upcycled Self, just made the New York Times bestseller list. Come on, bud. Hey.
Oh,
Tariq.
God.
Tariq Trotter, The Upcycled Self. Congratulations, bud. I know you
thank
worked
you,
hard on
thanks,
this.
Man. Wow. Thank you.
I want to quickly mention to tune into NBC tomorrow morning. The Roots and I will be in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. It's always fun to do that with the Roots. And then after the parade, they have an all-new football game. Okay. And then after the football game, we have an all-new show. Our guest will be Cher. So you can start and end your Thanksgiving with us. Yeah. Guys, it is time for tonight's show. Hashtag. Here we go. We do this thing every week where I send out a hashtag and I ask you guys to respond to that topic. So this week, I sent out the hashtag, my family is weird, and I asked you to post some funny or weird stories about your family members. Within minutes, it was a trending topic in the U.S., so thank you for playing along. Now I thought I'd share some of my favorite my family is weird posts from you guys. Here we go. This first one is from at Olive Garden, W8R.
What?
They say, one time my family got too drunk at Christmas, then ordered an Uber XL just to drive them around and look at decorations.
That's a great idea.
Yeah, Olive Garden, when you hear your family.
Yeah, XL.
This one's from at Wichita Cat. She says, we've secretly made a plan to pose my sister's boyfriend to the edge of the family pictures so it's easier to crop them out after they break up.
Genius.
This one's from Joe Pitsy. He says, my cousin Eric ate an entire Big Mac at 9 months old.
Wait, what? I don't know.
That's
that.
Not true. That's
he
pretty.
Didn't, first of all, he didn't eat it.
Yeah.
Somebody fed it to him, right?
I don't know. I wasn't there.
9 months old.
I think it's true. I think it's funny.
All right, it's weird.
This one's from at Toji Gan. He says, every time someone brings a new boyfriend or a girlfriend to my Thanksgiving, my dad will carve the turkey and cover his hand in fake blood and make it look like he sliced off his fingers.
Come on.
That's funny. This one is from at Jeffy Bozeman. He says, one year as a prank, we all woke up super early and left the house before my brother was awake to recreate Home Alone. When my brother finally woke up, he freaked out and called 911 because we thought we were all kidnapped except for him. This last one's from at Duncan Don't Nuts.
Oh.
He says, every year my grandma would wrap up random things around her house and give them to us for Christmas. I was the only 8-year-old with my own set of drink coasters. There you have it. Those are the Tonight Show hashtags. Check out more of our favorites. Go to tonightshow.com/hashtags. We'll be right back with more Tonight Show, everybody. Come on back. Hey, hey.